Sister, let me wipe your tears. Brother, let me bear your fears. Come on, every daughter, every son. Let us walk in love, for we are one. Though we walk along a broken road, we are here to bear each other's load. And forever,
Bethel. It is great to be celebrating 160 years. Welcome to everybody here, to our friends from Burford United Church. It's great to have you with us today. And to anybody who might be visiting with us for the first time, we welcome you and do indeed hope you find this as a place where you belong. Just a few announcements before we begin today. I hope that you were seeing what was on the screen as it was rolling through. I just wanted to highlight that there is an orange jacket that was left behind at the pie making Burford Day. We have a claim. So it's hanging in the entryway, Brenda. So it's there. You might have been missing it, so that's great. And also wanted to note that there are still a couple of tables waiting for you for trivia night next Saturday night at Burford United. And if you've got a team of four, or even if there's two of you, find two others or one of you. And so if you'd like to do that, you can contact Betty, I believe, and sign up for that. It's from 7 to 9:30, I think. Is that correct? Yes, and we look forward to that. I've got a team ready, Ron and Linda, and Miriam's going to be joining us, so come on out and compete. Should be a fun evening. And I believe Scott has an announcement. Yeah.
It was a beautiful day yesterday, and Petra and I spent most of it making jam. So there's the jam that we sell and that we make and we sell here. The fruit is brought in by folks from the congregation, and it ends up in our freezer at home. And so this yesterday we had rhubarb and strawberries, and we had some raspberries from our own garden. And so we made lots of jam, including some Splenda jam for those who are more on the diabetic end of things. So there's lots of jam out there, and The proceeds go to our work at the Blessing Center in Brantford, so feeding the hungry.
Wonderful. Thank you, Scott. So help yourself. And before you, and after you grab a jar of jam, please come downstairs. We've got lots of tables set up down there for a wonderful feast and potluck lunch and celebration together. So if you didn't bring anything, don't worry, because there's always tons of food. So please, please stay for a time of fellowship with each other after the service today. And it's my pleasure to welcome Reverend Kathy Diltz this morning. I think this is your first Sunday back after retirement, is it, in the pulpit? We feel honored, and we're glad to have you here today, and I know that you'll be a blessing to each of us this morning. So welcome. So come and worship, all you who love and serve the Lord, outsiders and insiders, old timers and newcomers, the young, the old, and the in-between. Come as you are, for this is God's house, a house of prayer for all people, and God welcomes each one of us who comes. Let us pray. No, let us sing. We're going to sing. I move the order of things. See, I'm so in tune with my routine. Let us pray and sing. Let us pray as we sing. How about that? Joyful, joyful, we adore you. For drawing us into community in this church that has been a place called home for so many over the last 160 years. Inspire us with the lives of those before us, those ancient ones who have lived here in faith and opened up and given away your love to all those who needed it. May you change us with a vision to continue here as a constant presence for those who travel through life, a community of welcome that cares for all believing into what is still yet to be. Teach us to discern your voice as those before us have discerned your voice, guided by its call and feeding on its promise of life and hope and belonging. May we hear your word this day, a comforting word in its familiar sound, yet a disturbing word in what it speaks anew and longs for us to become. Hold us within the faith of our forebears, those who chose to meet you here in this place where your miracle of grace abides. And may we be moved by that grace into all the places that make up our community, sharing what you have given abundantly like an ever-flowing stream. Call us from our past through the voices of our ancestors, in the songs they have sung and the prayers they have spoken that have shaped peace within this community. And may we join our voice with their voice in the one great song of love that will be lived and celebrated yet in and through our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
O my people, listen to my instructions. Open your ears to what I am saying. For I will speak to you in a parable. I will teach you hidden lessons from our past, stories we have heard and known, stories our ancestors handed down to us.
We will not hide these truths from our children. We will tell the next generation about the glorious deeds of the Lord, about his power and his mighty wonders.
For he issued his laws to Jacob. He gave his instructions to Israel. He commanded our ancestors to teach them to their children.
So the next generation might know them, even the children not yet born, and they in turn will teach their own children.
So each generation should set its hope anew on God, not forgetting his glorious miracles and obeying his commands.
Well, my friends, God's mercy is deeper than the depths of the sea, and God's grace is wider than the whole of the earth. Trusting in that mercy and that grace, let us make our confession before God and before each other. Would you pray with me? Holy God, we open our hearts to you this day and offer the truth of our lives, the fear that stifles us, the prejudice that blinds us, the ignorance that hobbles us, and the doubt that plagues us. Help us, we pray, that we will find courage in unlikely places, see the world with new and gracious eyes, move to those places where love is needed, and have faith that you are with us. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, rejoice and be glad when you hear the good news. You are forgiven. We are set free to go out into the world and be the loving, gracious, hopeful people of God. Hallelujah and amen.
To be always near. The scripture reading for this morning is an Old Testament reading, comes from the book of Joshua, chapter 4. When the entire nation had finished crossing over the Jordan, the Lord said to Joshua, "Select 12 men from the people, one from each tribe, and command them, take 12 stones from here out of the middle of the Jordan, from the place where the priest's feet stood. Carry them over with you and lay them down in the place where you camp tonight." Then Joshua summoned the 12 men whom he had appointed from the Israelites, one from each tribe. Joshua said to them, "Pass on before the ark of the Lord your God into the middle of the Jordan, and each of you take up a stone on his shoulder, according to the number of the tribes of the Israelites, so that this may be a sign among you when your children ask in time to come, 'What do these stones mean to you?' Then you shall tell them that the waters of the Jordan were cut off in front of the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord when it crossed over the Jordan. The waters of the Jordan were cut off, and so these stones shall be to the Israelites a memorial forever." Thanks be to God. Please pray with me. In praise of your love and faithfulness, O God, we worship you this day. Through all the years, your word of life has been a constant source of comfort and gift of grace for your people. Today, we too come with spirits awakened and hearts receptive to your word. Help us to hear what it is you have to say to us today, O God, that we may be made ready for all the new tomorrows you have in store for us. This we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, good morning.
Good morning.
It is a good morning to gather as sisters and brothers in Christ, as friends, to worship God and to give God thanks for all that he has done and is doing in this faith community. It is nice to be here with you, to see so many familiar faces, and to celebrate God's blessings together. Thank you for inviting me to be part of it. I know that there will be lots more time to visit following service this morning as we break bread together, and I look forward to that. But for now, for this moment, it is both a joy and a gift to be able to sit and to feel and to remember all that we celebrate together today. My thanks to Adrian for loaning me your congregation's three history books to help me get ready for this morning. What an amazing story they tell. As an avid genealogy and history buff, I know such stories are important because they help us to know who we are, what we hold dear, and that we belong to something bigger and more enduring than just ourselves. And that is such an important reminder for these times in which we live. Now, I have to admit, I'm a little bit curious. So I'm going to ask you to raise your hand if you were baptized here. Okay. If you attended Sunday school here. Okay, a few more. If you were married here. Okay. Raise your hand if you said goodbye to a loved one here. Raise your hand if you met a new friend here. All right. If you found comfort here. If you prayed for someone here. Yeah, I think that's everybody. All right, now I'm going to test your memories. Who here remembers when the building looked different than it does right now. Been some changes. How about when the old schoolhouse stood across the street? Yeah. Anybody go to that school? Okay, yeah. So raise your hand, or if you remember winter skating in the old shed. Yeah. Okay. How about the Happy Doubles Club? Or CGIT? Or Bethel Messengers? Or participating in God's good works to help meet a need in the community? I think that's pretty much all of you. Yeah. Now, maybe you have called this place home for many years. Maybe you are a recent addition to the family. But know that together you are inheritors of a story, a legacy of faith that has, is, and will continue to be a blessing in this little corner of God's world. And that is a very important thing. And the story of Bethel Stone Church is a testament to God's faithfulness and the truth of that promise that is given to us in Jesus, that with faith and, yes, a whole lot of hard work, life in God bears abundant fruit. And that is all of you. I can only imagine the faith that it took among those early pioneers who settled here as they worked to clear the land and plant the crops and cut the logs to fashion homes and a school, and as they built a community here. I can only imagine the hopes and the prayers, the fortitude of those early settlers who, out of love for God, built this beautiful place, this house of worship that quite literally was raised from the ground. The long back-breaking days it must have taken to dig up by hand rocks from the fields around here, to gather and to sort and to clean and to split those rocks and to set the stones that gave walls to this church. Not to mention the many hands that worked to paint the walls and craft the pews and sew the drapes and polish the brass and ready God's house, this Beth-El, for worship. Oh, the stories they must have told, the laughter they must have shared, the spirit-filled visions they must have had for what might be, and all that God would do through them, and all those who in time would come to call this place home. You know, I think if we listen for a moment, if we really listen with our hearts and with our spirits, we can still hear the echoes of the songs that they sang and the prayers that they uttered and the tears and the laughter that they shared that always mark our journey through this life. If we listen, we can hear them still. For though the years past are many, their hymns and prayers and faith remain soaked right into the paint. 160 years later, that great cloud of witnesses of which we too are part. So as we hold memories of them in our hearts today, let us pray and give God thanks. Please pray with me. Ever loving and ever faithful God, we thank you for the blessings of church that you have given to us in years past. Worship, fellowship, sharing, caring, learning, giving. Whether we are long-timers here at Bethel Stone Church or relative newcomers, your church and your people have been a gift in our lives. For the names and faces of those who, in the course of your loving service, have left their mark and goodness on us, we thank you. For the saints of yesteryear who have shown us by their words and actions what following Jesus looks like, we praise you. May all that they shared continue to live in us. and for songs to sing, prayers to offer, gifts to share, and a call to serve. We thank you, O God. Amen. And today, in our pausing, we take this moment to think about the present, the rich legacy of faith that you have inherited in this community is still yours to carry and to cherish and to celebrate together. And so I invite you to look around you today. Think about this place, these people, this time. What is it here at Bethel Church that gives you joy? What is it that fills your soul, that keeps you being part of the life and love in Christ that are this place? What are the stories of faith that inspire you today? What are the hymns that still lift your heart or bring a tear to your eye? Who are the ones who know your name and encourage you along life's way? How are you being invited to serve? What are the rituals of faith that ground you? Thank offering teas or potluck dinners, special services or roast beef dinners, pie-making days and friends in the socializing group, caring for one another in faith, new possibilities, new challenges, and new paths that God has percolating. And as always, an abundance of friendship. So let's pray. Ever-loving and ever-faithful God, we thank you for the blessings of church that you give us today. Worship, fellowship, sharing, caring, learning, giving. Whether we are long-timers here or relative newcomers, your church and your people here are a gift in our lives. For the names and faces of those who, in the course of your loving service, continue to reflect your light of love and goodness to us, we thank you. For the saints of today, who show us by their words and actions what following Jesus looks like, we praise you. May all that they share with us continue to live in us. And we pray today for those who are hurting, O God. Take care of them, whatever be their need. And for songs to sing, prayers to offer, gifts to share, and a call to serve, we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. And today in our pausing, we take this moment to think about the future, your future, the rich legacy of faith that you have inherited in this community is yours to cherish and to celebrate, but also to carry forward. So I invite you to look around and to think about this place and the people who are not here yet. What might they need? What might they bring that will bless all of you? How might we hear them even now? How might God yet fill your souls and give you joy as you open your hearts to meeting God in all the twists and turnings and surprises that time will bring? In a world that continues to change, how might God be calling you to live into this rich heritage that is yours to build and rebuild and adapt and change, just as your foremothers and fathers in the faith did so well, that others too may find anew the joy of being part of the life and love in Christ that are this place? The Hebrew people learned a very important lesson in their wilderness wanderings, that wherever they went, God went with them. By day, God was a pillar of cloud, and by night, a pillar of fire to lead them. When God deemed it time to pause a while, they worshiped him. They worshiped him in a tent of meeting. Nothing more than a few sticks and some bands of cloth, nothing fancy. You had to be able to put it up and take it down on a moment's notice. Because you see, when God says go, you gotta go. When God says rest, you gotta rest. When God says do, you gotta
do.
Following God means being flexible and adaptable and responsive to God's call, because God never stops moving. God never stops transforming and renewing. In today's passage, Moses, having led God's people to the edge of the promised land, they could literally see it. Now he now relinquishes the staff of leadership to another, to Joshua. Standing at the edge of the Jordan River, Joshua shows them the past that is behind them. Their future lies in a new land. To get there will require courage and trust and deep faith in their God, who has never and will never forsake them. God tells Joshua, "Have one from each of the 12 tribes take up a stone and place it in the river so that the waters may be held back, and the priests carrying the Ark of the Covenant, holding the stone of the Ten Commandments, might cross over on dry ground. Stones are placed, the waters part, the people in the ark pass on through to the promised land and to God's awaiting future. Once there, the people are instructed to move the stones from the place where God separated the waters and to set them up as an altar to the Lord to mark the place where God is. And when in the days to come your children ask, 'What do these stones mean?' say to them, 'This is where God is.' These stones set shall be a memorial to the Lord our God. From now on, these stones will mark a place where God dwells. They shall be a witness and a testimony to the goodness of God, and forever mark the place where the hand of the Lord reached out to save." Stone set, altar built, then what? Then what are God's people told to do? They're told to leave. The journey of faith takes them not just to the altar, but deeper into God's promise, deeper into life, deeper into the new future God has planned for them. It won't be easy. Worthwhile things seldom are. But having set the stones and marked the place where God is, the people are called to keep moving, keep praising, keep going with God. They don't know where it will lead them, what it might require of them, all that it might hold for them, but it is enough to know. All that they need to know is that God is with them. And in the moments when they do not think that they can, that they are too tired, too fearful, too uncertain, too hopeless, or just too anything, in all those moments, they can look to the stones, to their history, to their story, and to their identity, and rediscover time and time again that God indeed is with them. God is not done with them, and God has a future in store. Now, as then, these stones mark the place where God is. But even more, we know that through Christ Jesus, God dwells in the hearts of all God's people. Each of you brings yourself, your gift, your story, and when it all gets mixed up together in love and lifted up to God, miracles happen. I know that November 1st marks a new beginning for you all, a new step into collaborative ministry for both Bethel and Burford congregations. One of the many things I learned in your history book is that for 90 of your first 100 years, Bethel and Burford were part of the same pastoral charge. You shared a minister. In so many ways, this will be like a family reunion and an opportunity to celebrate together what God has done and God will do. It is written in 1 Peter chapter 2, "Come to him, the living stone, for you also are living stones, are being built into a spiritual house. And God says, "See, I lay a stone in Zion, a chosen and precious cornerstone, and those who trust in him will never be disappointed." Let us pray. Ever loving and ever faithful God, we thank you for the blessings of church that you have awaiting to give us in the years to come. Worship, fellowship, sharing, caring, learning, giving. Whether we are long-timers here at Bethel Church or newcomers or new neighbors we have yet to welcome, your church and your people here are a gift in our lives. For the names and faces of those who, in the course of your loving service, might show us new and creative ways to reflect your light and love in the world, we thank you. For the saints of tomorrow who will show us by their words and actions new possibilities for what following Jesus might look like, we praise you. May all that they will share with us continue to live in us as we walk the path of faith together. And for new songs to sing, new prayers to offer, new gifts to share, and faith's call to serve you, we thank you, O God. Amen. Amen. And we're going to sing, "Great is Thy Faithfulness."
Please stand.
Faithfulness, God our Creator,
Today we give thanks for the lives of all those who through this community of faith have shown in many ways what it means to follow Jesus. Our offering is one way in which we share in serving him in this generation. And so may the example of others who shared their faith in Christ so that we may believe inspire our generosity today. Let us pray. God of all generations, past, present, and future, we offer our gifts in gratitude for the inheritance of faithfulness we have received as followers of Jesus. Bless these gifts so that today's ministries may flourish and provide an inheritance for those who come after us, as you guide them into a future only you can see. We pray these things in Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen. And our offering will now be received.
Standing on this mountaintop, looking just how far we've come, knowing that for every step you were us, kneeling on this battleground, seeing just how much you've done, knowing every victory was your power in us. Scars and struggles on the way, but with joy our hearts can say, yes, our hearts can say. Never once did we ever walk alone. On our own. You are faithful, God, you are faithful.
Kneeling on this battleground, seeing just how much you've done, knowing every victory was your power in us. Scars and struggles on the way, but with joy our hearts can say, yes, our hearts can say.
I'm going to invite Petra and Scott to share a little piece of history this morning. This poem was given to Petra, I think, through yep. Heather Green, who's Heather's been cleaning out her house, we know that, and getting ready to move, and Heather came across this poem that was written for the 100th anniversary of Bethel Church by Mrs. Ernest Potroff. Of course, women were only named by their husband back in the day. I had to do some sleuthing here. And I reached out to Ron, Potroff, and this is Ron's mother, Pearl, who wrote this poem, Reveries of Bethel Church, and we'd like to share it with you this morning.
Go for it.
Okay. Oh, Bethel Church, you are so dear, and thankful are we this 100th year that this heritage left by our fathers of old, worth far more to us than a pile of pure gold. Still standing erect, you make our hearts glad. You are a monument to the faith they had.
Let's go back in history and think of the time when our forefathers came from many a clime to settle here, to settle there. Their joys and sorrows all to share. It was not easy, the paths they trod, to cut the timber or plow the sod, to build the homes which they first had, and insulate them well with mud.
Next came the school down the road a spell. The sons and daughters must read and spell. Boys will be boys, and had many a trick. The master, I heard, had a good hickory stick.
Then when Sunday morning rolled around, whether sun or rain or snow on the ground, all who were able to the schoolhouse trod to hear the truth read by some man of God.
How good the Lord heaven and earth had made, and to look to him for all their aid. Our fathers toiled on in these lands, and God did bless the work of their hands. The children grew to take their place like sons and daughters of any race. The fathers saw that all was well. Brand new plans they began to tell. We will build a church, no easy task. All made of stone, it will surely last.
The land was donated by a Mr. Cope. The men were courageous and full of hope. The foundation was dug, the cornerstone laid, and not one man had ever been paid.
Now underneath you, cornerstone, have you some secrets all your own? Hidden all these years so long in a box so very strong? If message there is, it may never be told, but I'm sure there is on all written in gold.
The stones were hauled from the farms nearby. I'm sure they were not spit with the very first try. The stones were heavy and some were rough. They had to be sorted for color and such.
The hands were calloused, the backs would ache, but not one thing did their spirit break. The walls grew steadily, folk looked on with pride. Soon it was ready to clean up inside. To do the painting and build the pews, many hands were needed, not just a few. To finish the altar, the pulpit to get, plenty to do, not all through yet.
And then there arose a very long shed to shelter the horses, Bill, Dan, or Ned. In one end, there was an enclosed stall. The minister's horse often kicked in the wall.
And so, dear church, as we come to you, we think of those who were so true, whose faith was fixed in God above and built this church to be the hub. From springs out to the countryside, love of God both far and wide.
Dear Lord, may we at this century time attune our lives to thy life sublime. So if storms should come or the atom blast and shake down these walls so strong at last, the Church of Christ will live in each heart and the Savior's love will never depart.
Thank you.
Let's pray. Loving God, who guided our forebears, we offer unto you a prayer of thanks and ask your blessing on all those who have served and worked in this branch of Christ Church for so many years. We thank you for every memory that our celebration revives and for the great number of witnesses who have made the 160th anniversary of our church an occasion for celebration. We pray that you will deepen within each of us a sense of gratitude for the many sacrifices made for us by those who have gone before us, and thereby find this church a place of refreshment and strength. May we continue to see by faith the needs of those around us and the needs of those who shall come after us, and do all that is possible to show them our witness in word and deed of the riches of life with Christ. We thank you for the blessing of our sisters and brothers of Burford United Church. And we pray that as we move forward together, sharing time and resources and fellowship and faith, we may be blessed in our collaboration and bring glory and honor and praise to you in all that we say and do. And now, O God, we bring our prayers for the church, the body of Christ, that we might truly live the unity we receive through the Holy Spirit. We pray for the nations of the world that they may live in peace with one another and promote justice for all. We pray for all people that we may be good stewards of the earth. For the people of our society that we may be transformed to live as caring neighbors to each other. For the sick and the suffering that they may be transformed by your healing presence. And for all families and households, that their struggles and joys may find their fulfillment in your love. And for the dying, that they may be comforted by your presence. And so today we lift up those who have been named in this community, and we remember Ralph, Helena, Ed, Alexandra, and for many others who find themselves facing challenges in their life at this time. God, our strength, change us by your grace. Stand in our midst and grant us unity and peace through Jesus Christ our Lord. And with the words he taught, we pray together saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And our final hymn this morning is On Bethel Road, which was written for the 150th anniversary of Bethel. And the words are written by Sarah Graham. And the tune is To In Christ Alone, which is written by Keith and Kristen Getty. So I invite us to stand as we are able.
And day by day, we make our choice.
can't see it. Just as Joshua had the Israelites set stones to mark the place where God dwells, as your ancestors in faith did here, we too are living stones. And by God's grace, God's spirit of light and love dwell within us all. So go out to mark, to make your mark in this world, and continue to share the stories and gifts of faith that you have received in this place. And may what you do here together in all the years to come enable others to discover, because of who you are and what you do, that Bethel Stone United Church and Bethel and Burford United Churches, just as you have always, this is the place where God dwells. And may the peace of Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit guide you and be with you now and evermore. Amen.
May God.